Hi everyone, I'm Erin Bassett, and today I'm going to show you how to use your ScanNCut to create this cute Valentine's Day decor.
Okay, let's go ahead and get started. I have my 12 by 12 canvas, and I want to go ahead and cut out some templates so I know where to place everything on my piece. So let's go ahead and get our mat. And I'm using one of the new ScanNCut mats. It's for both the ScanNCut and DesignNCut. And I'll start off by just placing it right on here. Smoothing it down. And now we'll just insert it into the machine. Okay, so let's go ahead and click on Patterns and Basic Shapes and scroll down to the hearts. So I think I just passed it. So on the fifth screen, there is this perfect looking heart right there. Now, if this is too perfect for you, you don't want this perfect height and width, you can go ahead and click this button, which will separate these, and you'll be able to just increase the width or the height. And then once again, once you lock it into place, when you hit it, it'll increase or decrease both the height and the width. So I want mine to be about 10 inches ish. And so I'll just increase it. Let's see, maybe about that. I'm gonna unlink it, make this be a little bit more. Okay, so I think that's pretty good, about 10 inches by 10 and a half inches, more or less. Okay, so here is my heart, and I'm gonna put it in the center. Of course, it doesn't really matter where it is on there because it's just the template. And now we can hit okay and cut, and make sure you change your blade settings if you need to. And then when you're ready, go ahead and hit start. Okay, so let's see. So there is our heart. Here is it on the canvas. So it looks like it'll be a great size right there. So next thing you need to do is go ahead and gather your cardstock. And I picked colors that would just do that ombre look to it. I'm gonna have the darker on the bottom, lighter on top. Of course, you could flip that around and have the reverse. You could just do three colors if you want. However you wanna work this, it's perfectly fine because this is your project. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing, cut out the same amount of hearts out of each of these papers, and that way I'll be able to really rearrange them exactly how I want them. So I might have some leftover hearts, and those will be perfect to use on cards or any other Valentine's Day decor. Okay, so again, we're just going to stick our paper onto our mat. And make sure it's smooth on there well. Okay, and now I'm going to load it into my machine. Okay, now I'm just going to hit the home button so we can go back, erase all this, and again go into patterns and find that heart again. And if you wanted to, you could use one of these hearts that have the like little scallop around it. You can see those are kind of cute. There's one with even more scalloped. I'm going to stick to just plain hearts though. And I'm going to have each heart be about an inch. Okay, so I'm going to have it be 1 inch size hearts. And I am going to increase the number that I'm doing on this. I'm going to do 20 of each color and tilt to set. And you can see that it's just set them right on there. Now, if you wanted to change how they're oriented, you can just go ahead and click on this and be able to change it around. You can see that it changes them so that they fit on the page however you'd like. So I am just going to click that. I guess it's okay. So let's go ahead and click OK and cut. And this paper is a little thicker, so I'm going to increase my blade depth and hit start. And once it's finished, pop it out of there, and then you can take that over to your work surface. Okay, now I'm just going to cut out the pink one. And the lighter pink one. And then the very lightest pink one. Okay, so we have our hearts already cut out, and now we are ready to go. I am just going to take this and center it on there. I am using this air-soluble pen that comes with some of the ScanNCuts, but it is sold separately. And this pen, it's meant to be used with fabric. If you're used to using fabric, you know that a lot of times you need to make marks on there, and there's pens that are either air-soluble or water-soluble to be able to remove them once your project is finished. So I'm going to be using this, and I'm going to go ahead, and I don't need to trace the whole thing. Of course, if you want to, you can. I'm just going to make some dots on here that kind of, or dashes, I guess, that just kind of give me an idea of where my boundaries of this heart are. And thankfully, it will just dissolve or evaporate, I guess, within a couple days at the most. Okay, so then I have a good idea of where to put all these other hearts. Now I'm going to start off with my dark colored hearts down here. And I can get, you know, pretty close to that edge if I want to, or right on it. And if you want to put them random, you can do random. If you want them all lined up, you can do lined up. And the only thing you really have to decide is, of course, where to put your hearts and how close you want to them together, and then where to have the break in color. So I want there to be a lot of red on there to ground it, but they don't have to be perfectly placed or anything. Then I'm going to get my next color of pink and just continue that on. Okay, so there is all my hearts on there. Now I just need to glue these into place. Okay, so I am going to use foam adhesive, and these are the little tiny squares of it that I'm gonna adhere these onto here. So it'll pop them up and give it a little bit more dimension. I'm just sticking one right on the back side, just one. Okay, so we got all those hearts on there. You can see they're all popped up. Super cute. I love how it turned out so far. Now let's go ahead and add some more details. Okay, so next thing we're gonna do is go ahead and take some thread, and I went ahead and threaded it already through my needle and put a knot at the end. And now I am just going to make little dashes of stitches around there. So on the back side, of course, you're gonna have your wood frame. So there might be times when you have to get underneath it, but hopefully there's not too many. It'll just be right there, right there, right there, right there, and of course at that point. So I am just gonna find right there and start my stitch. And you can make these as long or as little as you want. I think that's about good. And you know, I'm not worried if they are not all 100% perfect, if they're more spaced out, less spaced out. You know, it's handmade, so it's supposed to look handmade. Okay, so I'm just going to continue this all the way around my heart shape.
And here is our finished project with all those cute little hearts on it. For more information about ScanNCut, go to scanandcut.com. And for more ideas and inspiration, visit erinbassett.com.